now you can talk. Talk!
Yes. we start again about your studio. No? You told me about your studio. Can you say a little bit about the studio? There is so much chaos in it. And can you tell me a little bit about...
Absolutely. All right. So, okay. So first thing is, like I was telling you earlier, you know, when I grew up, you know, I was looking through books of Picasso and Francis Bacon, and an important thing that was always in the books was their studios. And apart from really falling in love with Bacon's work, I fell in love with the studio, and I just thought that that is the life that I want. You know, that's the freedom that I want, you know, to be able to live in this chaos. It just is heaven, you know, that was the idea, you know, that you could almost escape from society and live in this world that you can alter yourself, you know. Mm-hmm.
And you lived there for more than 12 years, or you
told me? Yes, for about 10 years I lived in that house. And in the new house that I moved into now, it's already starting to look a little bit like that. So wherever I move to, I just start working like that. Because the other thing about it, I think that's important for me, is I always felt that if you live in a very clean, very neat environment, then you will never go wild and make the crazy paintings. So it's almost like, you know, like if you have to keep your floors clean, you're going to worry about dripping paint on the floor. So if the environment's already crazy, then you wouldn't care too much about other things. You can just do anything that the painting requires. If it requires that you throw a whole can of paint over it, or so it allows for that. Plus the other thing is that it allows you to change what you do. You know, if today I feel like making a photograph, you know, if I want to smash a hole in the ceiling and make a photograph of that, you know, then I can do that, then that would be a work. So it's just a freedom and an environment that you could create to sort of live out your fantasy, really, you know.
And now you moved to another house, and it's now minimalistic, or?
It's still a little bit minimalistic, but it's slowly getting a little bit crazy, you know.
It starts
because at the moment, I don't really treat it as an installation. I really just treat it as a space to do whatever you want to do in. And you can see with the floor, the papers on the floor is, I laid that down in any space I work in. So the new space already has the papers on the floor. And that's a great device because you're looking at references all the time, but without directly copying anything. So whatever you're surrounded by filters it somehow into your space. So if I'm interested in, say, birds, for example, for a month, then I'll go out and buy a whole bunch of books on birds and I'll just throw the papers all over the floor. And I know that somehow those things will end up in the work because you're surrounded by it all the time. And then it also picks up dirt, and the papers become really interesting objects in themselves through time. So, you know, plus the other thing is the practical thing that it offers is that if you're making canvases and you're throwing a lot of paint around, if you were doing it on a clean floor like this, if the next day you walked in the studio, you would still be tracing paint all over the floor. So what's great about this is if it becomes too much paint, then you just throw a new layer of paper and then your floor's clean again.
Yeah, okay.
You know what I mean? It's like a very good practical thing, but also to feed your work, you know, and it, you know, so I believe the environment that you live in has a direct impact on the work you make, so then you can construct your environment to help the work.
May I introduce you to Susanne Ristow?
Yeah.
She is a colleague, she is also an artist. Susanne, möchtest du eine Frage stellen? Was würde dich interessieren?
I was wondering actually when I saw the first picture coming in about, you know, revelation and concealment. I was really kind of interested in whether you were thinking about covering things and recovering things and, things like that.
I suppose, I don't know, that's a tough one because that's something I've never really thought about. The idea of concealment.
I was also thinking of it when I look at these pictures, actually, at the pictures of your studio, because it's also kind of, you know,
it's kind of theater
showing and you know? Disguises as well.
Ah, that's very true. Well, because yes, and in that way you create a set like you would in a play, you know. And that disguises the reality of the space.
Yeah, it's also
but
kind of veiled, no, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, I feel a little bit like there's something like a veil on each picture of yours. And you were talking about chaos. I don't actually see that it's so crazy, your kind of painting. It's more, I think it's quite...
The painting is very, very controlled.
Exactly, yes. I wanted to say.
But the space has this feeling of chaos, even though everything has a function, you know.
Yeah.
It looks more chaotic, I think, on the outside. But it's chaos in the sense that if you go in, you're bound to get paint all over you somehow from walking past something. Everything's full of wet paint. Everything's dirty. So there is a kind of chaos in that. But in the actual working of it, it's
completely different.
Yeah, the result is, but you know, and the same goes for Bacon. If you look at Bacon's paintings, super precise, you know,
exactly.
Not a mark where it shouldn't be, but same thing, you know. And I think that it's almost like out of that, you know, I don't know how you could say it, but if you look at the way things are laid out, you know, you have rows of paint in tubes, and then you have brushes, and then you have, so everything has a function, you know, so, and everything's laid out for maximum work.
It's a kind of technology, I would say. It's
painting,
I mean,
technology,
it's a special,
it's a system.
Yeah, special kind of technology. When did you go the first time to Dublin? I was wondering too.
I've never been there.
You've
but
never
I,
been
I,
there
but
to
I,
see the
no,
original.
No, no. I saw the first time I've seen a real Francis Bacon work, just paintings, in real life, was today at the Museum of Crafts.
No,
yes.
Can't believe it.
Yeah, I've seen Picasso's and Matisse's and so on before.
I can't believe
but
it.
I've never seen a Bacon in real life. And also I've only read about and seen pictures and like looked at podcasts of how they moved Bacon's studio back to his original birthplace and how they dismantled the whole thing and meticulously re-packed it or constructed, which is phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
I love
it. Hello.
Thank you. So, yeah.
Okay, so... let's go over to your is this your wife or your friend?
Yes, my wife.
Let's go over to the Duesseldorf.
We have both separately been to Berlin before.
Oh, yes.
Years before.
Mm-hmm. Years before. I lived there for a little while. But I must say that I like Duesseldorf better.
Yes?
I do. Well, it's very quiet.
We're in a different time of our lives, perhaps a little bit older. And the peace and the quiet in the streets, it's amazing. It's just wonderful.
It's also different. The difference is here in the sort of other
fires.
Yes. Berlin, there are every gallery.
All the youth is in Berlin.
Berlin is a little bit scary.
Yeah.
It's a bit terrifying. You could lose yourself in Berlin and never be found again.
Too much party in Berlin.
Yeah.
Yes, it's much.
Düsseldorf feels like a good place to work.
Yes, I think so. So
like
and you are very close to the academy.
Yes.
Very close. It's all
and almost incredible, you know, I mean what is that school that so many famous painters are from?
Yes, the Kunstakademie.
Is that it?
Is it?
Didn't Richter teach there or something? Or what is it?
Yes,
and a lot of incredible photographers
school,
are from here, right?
Yes.
So
the Becker School is the start here, so and all the famous.
I mean, the amount of culture that's in a city like this is phenomenal. You know, we're not used to it, so.
Yes, it's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
It's very incredible to be exposed to all of it.
Good.
Fine. Mm-hmm. Sorry,
thank you so much. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay.